the length of a cross belt drive. The previous one is the length of the open belt drive, right? So more or less the equations are going to be similar, only you will have a small change on the final term, right? So R1 and R2, radius of the larger and smaller pulleys, right? R1 is the radius of the larger pulley and R2 is the radius of the smaller pulley. X is the distance between the center of pulleys. X is the distance between these two pulleys. And L is the total length. So L is the total length of this belt, right? From the geometry of the figure, we find that O2M, right? O2M will be perpendicular to O1E. Will be perpendicular to O1E because this is a tangent which is perpendicular to the point and line joining the tangent, right? This is perpendicular. Angle MO2O1 is equal to alpha. MO2O1, right? This angle is the alpha, right? We know that the length of the belt. So now the total length of the belt is arc GJE, right? Arc GJE, right? This is GJE, the area in contact with the larger pulley, right? The length which is in contact with the larger pulley. This is GJE. Then I have EF, right? So this length is which is not in contact with the larger pulley and smaller pulley. Then I have FKH arc, FKH, this arc. So this is the arc which is in contact with the smaller pulley. Then we have HK, right? So this region is not in contact with these two pulleys. So this total length of GJE plus EF plus FKH plus HGE will give you the total length of the belt drive, right? Total length of the belt drive. We can write it as 2 into arc JE, right? Arc JE plus EF plus FK, right? So this part into 2 will give you the total length, right? JE plus EF plus FK into 2, which means HK plus HG plus GJ, right? So this will give you the total length, all right? From the geometry of the figure, we find that, now we'll find the sine alpha, right? So if this is alpha, then this is alpha. Sine alpha is equal to O1M, okay? O1M minus O1E upon O1, O2, right? Here is the alpha, you see, O1M upon O1, O2. Okay, this O1M is equal to O1E plus EM. Okay, O1M is equal to O1E plus EM divided by the O1, O2 that is already there, right? O1E is equal to R1Y. This is the radius of the larger pulley, that is O1E, which is equal to R1. EM, that is this length, which is equal to O2F, that is the radius of the smaller pulley, that is R2, right? Divided by O1, O2. This O1, O2 is the distance between these two pulleys, that is X. Since alpha is very small, right? So alpha is very small, we can write sine alpha as alpha. I told you, right? If the angle is very small, you can write the angle as sine of that particular angle as directly alpha. So alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2. Okay. Alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2. We will find the length JE. Okay. Arc length JE. So we know arc length JE is equal to the radius of the arc into the angles subtended by this arc. So JO, that is R1, into this angle 90 plus alpha, that is pi by 2 plus alpha. So JE is equal to R1 into pi by 2 plus alpha, right? JE into pi by 2 plus alpha. Then I have FK, right? Here I have the arc FK, right? This arc FK. So I need to find the length of this arc. So So that is radius R2 into the angle subtended by this angle, that is 90 plus alpha. Okay, so R2 into 90 plus alpha, that is R2 into pi by 2 plus alpha, right? R2 into pi by 2 plus alpha. Then I have EF, okay? EF, that EF is equal to MO2, right? EF is equal to MO2. So by this, by the correlation, I can find MO2 is equal to under root of square of O1 O2 minus square of O1 M, right? So MO2 is equal to under root of O1 O2 whole squared minus O1 M whole squared. So O1 O2, the length is X squared minus R1 plus R2 whole squared, right? This is R1, this is R2 whole squared, okay? So when you take this X out, X is equal to, sorry, X out, you will have X into under root of 1 minus R1 plus R2 by X whole squared, okay? So again, we expand it with the binomial theorem. There you will have X into 1 minus half into R1 plus R2 whole squared plus, that will go, right? But we need only the term, this one, right? The larger term, X minus R1 plus R2 by 2X. So you expand it and you will solve it. You will have X minus R1 plus R2 whole squared by 2X, right? Substituting the values of JE from equation 3, so that is this arc length, FK from equation 4, that is this arc length, plus EF, that is this length, in equation. So we know the equation is this length plus this length plus this length into 2, right? So it means 2 into arc length JE, that is R1 into pi by 2 plus alpha, right? R1 into pi by 2 plus alpha plus EF. EF is this length. So by the expansion from the binomial theorem, we have X minus R1 plus R2 whole squared upon 2. Okay, that is this length. Plus this curve FK, that is R2 into angle subtended pi by 2 plus alpha, that is R2 into pi by 2 plus alpha. Okay. Now we'll remove the brackets. R1 into pi by 2 plus R1 into alpha plus X minus R1 plus R2 whole squared by 2X plus R2 into pi by 2 plus R2 into alpha, right? Now we will group them, right? So here also I have a pi by 2. Here also I have a pi by 2. I'll group it. So pi by 2 into R1 plus R2, right? Pi by 2 into R1 plus R2. Here I have an alpha. There also I have an alpha. So alpha into R1 plus R2, right? Alpha into R1 plus R2. Then I have X minus R1 plus R2 whole squared by 2X. Okay. Now I multiply it with 2. So 2 into pi by 2 into R1 plus R2. So this 2 and this 2 will be cancelled out. So pi into R1 plus R2, that's here. Okay. This 2 into alpha, 2 alpha into R1 plus R2, that is there. Plus 2 into X, 2X, that's over here. This 2 into this term, that is 2 and 2 will be cancelled. So R1 plus R2 whole squared by X. Okay. We have this. Substituting the value of alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by X. So we have already found this alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 upon X, right? Alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 upon X. So when we substitute this instead of alpha, first you will have X pi into R1 plus R2, that's already there. 2 into alpha, that is R1 plus R2. Here is an R1 plus R2 by 2. So that is 2 into R1 plus R2 by 2 by X, right? Alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by X, that's here. Then into R1 plus R2, that's there. Plus 2X minus R1 plus R2 whole squared by X, okay? Now, when you solve it, pi into R1 plus R2, that's already there. 2 into R1 plus R2, here is an R1 plus R2, so then it will be squared. So 2 into R1 plus R2 whole squared by X plus 2X, minus R1 plus R2 whole squared by X. Okay. When you solve this, you will have pi into R1 plus R2, that's already there, plus 2X, that's also here. Here what will happen? 2 into R1 plus R2 whole squared by X minus R1 plus R2 whole squared by X. You will have plus R1 plus R2 whole squared by X. Okay. So when you solve these two, you will have plus 1 R1 plus R2 whole squared by X. So this in terms of radius. Everything is in radius, right? R1 is in radius, R2 radius, everything is in radius. When you change it into diameter, wherever you are having the radius, you need to put d1 by 2, right? That you know. So here, instead of R1, you will put d1 by 2. Instead of R2, you will put d2 by 2. That 2 will come out. So pi by 2 into d1 by d1 plus d2 plus 2x. There's no change in the dx, right? So here, R1 plus R2 whole squared by x. So R1 is equal to D1 by 2 plus R2 is equal to D2 by 2 whole squared by X. So here we have D1, there will be a square. For D2, there will be a square. So you will have 4X. So if in terms of diameter, you will have pi by 2 into D1 plus D2 plus 2X plus D1 by D2 whole squared by 4, right? So in open belt, you will have minus over here. In the closed belt, you will have plus over here. That's the difference.